Hello friends, welcome to this video. In the previous video, we learned how Ramu and his family were thinking about taking a loan from the bank to start a new venture. Today we will see how Ramu and Shyam are purchasing things for their shop. So, our work has finally started. Today I will go to market to buy things for my shop. That is why I have made the list too.
Dad, how did you find out how much money is needed to start a stationery shop? Can you tell me?
Son, before starting any work, we need to make a list of things we need for that work. Using that list, we will be able to identify how much money is needed to start the work. For instance, I made this list. I have entered the number of items I need, but I need to enter the amount. Then I will get to know how much money is required to buy the things.
How is that, Dad?
Suppose one book costs rupees 20 and I want to buy 5 in total. Then how much money is required to buy the books? 20 multiplied by 5, that is 100 rupees.
Oh, wow, Dad!
Come on, let us go and buy things and see how much money do we really need. How are you, Mohan? I want these things to open my shop. Tell me the cost of these things.
Brother Ramu, one book costs rupees 40 and one pen costs rupees 10.
Look, Shyam, the shopkeeper told us the cost of one item. Now, can you tell me the total cost?
The cost of books is 40 into 100, that is 4000 rupees. Cost of pen is 10 into 150, that is 1500 rupees. The total cost is 4000 plus 1500, that is 5500.
Yes, that's how we find out the total cost. Okay, now take 1/4 of the books we bought and give them to your uncle and ask him to pay rupees 1500 for them.
Okay, Dad.
But first tell me how many books you will give him. You can pause the video if you want and think about it.
Hundred divided by 4 is 25. So I will give 25 books to him. But Dad, 25 books cost 1000 rupees and we are taking 1500 rupees from uncle.
Yes, son. This is the profit. When we buy an item at a lesser price and sell it at a higher price, then we will get a profit. If we sell the books costing 1000 rupees for 1500 rupees, then our profit is rupees 500.
Oh, wow, Dad. This is very interesting.
Shyam stopped at grocery store while coming back home. His mother had told him to buy 4 kgs of flour, for which she gave him 200 rupees. Shopkeeper told him that the cost of 1 kg of flour is 45 rupees. Shyam wasn't sure if the money he had would be enough. What is your opinion? Will Shyam be able to buy the flour in the given money? Or will he need more? Think for a while. You can pause the video if you want. If the cost of 1 kg flour is 45 rupees, so the cost of 4 kgs of flour would be 4 times 45, that is 180 rupees. That means Shyam can easily buy 4 kgs of flour from the money given and he will be left with 20 rupees. In this video, we have learned about finding the total cost and finding the profit along with Shyam and Ramu. Thank you.